and welcome to English class of standard 12th. The poem that we'll be studying today is Money by William H. Davis. The poem Money by William H. Davis is about the importance we give to possessing money. We begin with the icebreakers. Let us discuss the importance of money. Money is used as capital in business, that is, money is used to start a business. Money is used by traders to fill up stocks. That is, traders use it for buying and selling stocks, shares. It is used by common man for buying essentials and necessities. Everyone uses money for transport fare. They also use it as food bills. They also use it for wages and so on. Next question of icebreakers is complete the web. The topic here in the web is money spent judiciously, that is, money is spent properly. Paying fees for bright students who are economically backward, this can be one of the ways in which money can be spent judiciously. Next one is used to help women set up small business. In this way, money can be used or spend judiciously. Next one is to support fine arts, crafts like music, traditional art forms and so on. Money can be spent judiciously. First one is already given, donation for poor and needy. So in this way, money can be spent judiciously. Next question is make a list of the good qualities of your friend. You need to write the good qualities of your friend. I have written two of the good qualities of my friend. You can take it as an example and continue with the other two qualities. First one is calm and good tempered at times, helpful and concerned about anyone in trouble. So in this way you can continue. Share your views on money is the root of all evils. Let's see how money is the main evil or the root of all evil. Money is a resource. Resources should be available and they should be used in times of need. Crime increases because of money, and also normal life, it becomes unstable because of money. Even if you have more money or less money, the normal life is going to be disturbed. Much money will be there, crime will increase. Accumulation of money. If the person is accumulating too much of money, there will be less money in the society. It will cause upset in the society. So, important resources, it automatically becomes an evil in the society. This is how we can explain that money is the root of all evils. Now, here is the question which asks you whether you lend money to your friend, and if yes, give the reason, and if no, then also we have to give the reason. Let us see when are the correct times to lend the money. In the yes column, we can say that yes, he or she comes from an economically disadvantaged background. That time money can be lent. When he or she is a bright student and wants to study well and find employment. When he or she falls sick, if she does not have good nourishment, then too money can be lent. When are you going to say no to lend money? You can find that when he or she gets enough money to spend, then also if the person is asking for money, you can reject it. When he or she wastes time in movies and malls, then too money should not be lent. When he or she has no intention of returning borrowed money, then too money cannot be lent. So in this way, you can give your own reasons and complete this table. Let us know about the poet and the writer William H. Davis. He was born in the year 1871 and his death was in the year 1940. William H. Davis, he was a Welsh poet and writer. That is, he used to write in Welsh language. It is the language spoken in Wales, which is near England in UK. Now he has spent a major part of his life as a tramp or hobo in UK. That is, he has spent a major part of his life as a person who travels from place to place on foot in search of food or for work, or he has traveled as a beggar, both in UK and USA. He became a peddler and a street singer in England. That is, he used to travel from place to place to sell some goods or some products. So he was also a street singer in England. After several years of wandering life, that is, moving from place to place, he published his first volume, The Soul's Destroyer and Other Poems. This is the name of the book. The poem Money, it tells us about the rich man who wants to be a poor man to find the real happiness. It is when we do not have money or have lost our money, we realize how important the money is. At the end, the poet says that now he doesn't have money. He has true friends, though they may be few. Let us begin with the poem Money. We all know what money is. Money is the thing with which we can buy all the necessities of life, all the luxuries in life. So we believe that money brings happiness. But let us see what is the view of the writer. The writer says, when I had money, money oh. That is, when I had money, he is expressing sadness with the letter O. He says that I knew no joy till I went poor. He says that I was not happy. I did not know what joy is till the time I went poor, till the time I became poor. He says, for many a false man as a friend, that is, many a false people, many a false men, they came to him as a friend, came knocking all day at my door. They used to come to him knocking his door all throughout the day. Then felt I like a child that holds a trumpet that he must not blow, because a man is dead. I dared not speak to let this false world know. Now here the poet is saying he felt like a child who is holding a trumpet, and he is told that he must not blow a trumpet because a man is dead. He also did not dare to speak about the false friends to the world, because he wanted that the world should not know that he is being cheated by false friends. Much have I thought of life and seen how poor men's hearts are ever light. He says that he has thought a lot about the life, and he has seen that the poor men's hearts, they are every time in a light mood. They are always happy. Ever light means they are happy. And he has seen that their wives, they do hum like bees. That is, they hum means here it is sing with closed lips. That is, they are always singing. They are always happy about their work from morning till night. They are happy to work from morning till night. They do it by singing, that is humming with closed lips. The poet says that, so when I hear these poor ones laugh and see the rich ones coldly frown, which means that when the poet hears the poor people laughing, and when he sees that the rich ones, they are just coldly frown, which means they are just making faces or showing the expressions of sadness. He says that the poor men think I, means he is thinking that the poor men should not go up, they should not become rich. Instead, he feels that so much as rich men should come down, which means that rich men, instead of that, the rich men should come down, means they should become poor. This is the view of the poet. The poet concludes in the last stanza, and he says that when I had money, money oh. That is, he exclaims with sadness, and he says that when I had money, oh, my many friends proved all untrue. That is, all his friends had become untrue, that is, they had become false. And he says further that, but now I have no money, oh. Means he is saying that now I am having no money, and then exclaims, oh, my friends are real, though very few. Now he says, when I had become poor, now he has very few friends, but these friends are real. Now this poem is written by William H. Davies. Here he concludes saying that when he is poor, he is having real friends with him now. And when he was rich, he was surrounded by all false men, all the false friends. With this, we end the poem, Money. The poet has made us realize the value of money. I think you have understood the explanation of the poem, Money. Thanks for watching. Meet you in the next class with the brainstorming part of the poem, Money. Goodbye till then.
So friends, don't forget to subscribe the channel and share the video and also to like the video. Thanks for watching.